Robert Mangaliso Sobukwe was born in the small town of Rafrainet, 5 December 1924. He began his studies at the University of Fort Hare, whereby Utah Nelson Mandela was studying, and the late Robert Mugabe of Zimbabwe. In 1954, he became a lecturer at the University of Witwatersrand, which is now known as Vets University. He was teaching linguistics course of language. In 1959, he joined the organization that was known as PAC, which stands for Pan African Congress. The PAC was the organization that was formed in order to fight against apartheid laws in South Africa. Laws such as Group Areas Act, whereby blacks were being grouped according to races in 1950. Laws such as separate amenities, whereby blacks were being separated on the public facilities in 1953. The well-known law was the law that was referred as a pass law system, 1952. A pass law system was the law that was introduced in order to control the movement of black people. In the pass law system, blacks were being forced to carry the pass. That pass was known as Dom Pass in Afrikaans. In English, means stupid pass. That pass indicates the name of a person. It has a picture of you. It also has the physical address of where are you staying. What will happen is, if you are then found by police, maybe at night or morning patrolling, not having your pass on you, you will then be beaten up by police and arrested for 3 months in jail. And your bail will be 60 rand. During the time of apartheid, 60 rand was a huge amount of money. You had to work for 6 months in order for you to get 60 rand, in order for you to have bail. Mm-hmm. On the 21st of March 1960, Robert Mangaliso Sobukwe and other members of PAC gathered together and organized marches around South Africa. They organized marches in the township called Langa and Gugulethu here in Cape Town. But the biggest march that they were having, it was on Sharpeville, whereby they were having 5,000 protesters there. Sobukwe demanded all of the black protesters, they must go to their nearest police stations and demanded to be arrested in order to fight against this pass law system. But there was a sad incident that happened in Sharpeville. The police started to panic. They are seeing large numbers of people coming close to their prison. As well, they started to panic and they started to shoot. By shooting, they shoot and they killed 69 people, and 180 were injured, and thousands were arrested. That day was known as Sharpeville Massacre. Mm. It is now known as a Human Rights Day in order to commemorate those who died fighting against apartheid in South Africa. Mm. After the incident of Sharpeville, Sobukwe was then arrested in Orlando with other members of PAC. He was then charged with incitement. He was then taken to Pretoria Central, whereby he served 3 years there. After serving his 3 years in Pretoria Central, the government then sit at the parliament and decide about the future of Sobukwe, whether they must release him or they must take him back in Pretoria Central. But they ended up coming up with a claw that was known as Sobukwe claw, which was only meant for him. That's when they decided to take him here on the island in 1963. The house on your left-hand side with the water barrel on it, this one, this is where he was staying. He was staying alone here in the island. He was separated from the ex-political inmate that you met for your first part of your tour. He was being looked after by 6 warders here, and the warders were given access to shoot, to kill, if he was running away. I won't say Sobukwe was kept as a prisoner here at Kyoto. He was wearing his own clothes. He was eating whenever he wanted to eat. He was having access to radio as well. But the only thing that was denied for Sobukwe that was very, very painful, Sobukwe was denied the opportunity to talk with anyone. He was not even allowed to talk with the warders that look after him. Those that were working in the limestone quarry, coming from the maximum security prison, walking to the limestone quarry on top, they will see Robert Mangaliso Sobukwe here outside and they will greet him. Sobukwe won't beg you to. He was not allowed to communicate with anyone. The only thing he will do is he will just scoop a sand with his hand and he will let it filter. And that was the message to them, that you are the son of the soil. You must fight until the end in order for you to get your freedom. But during his serving in the island, he then developed a vocal cause. His vocal cause stopped working due to he was not talking to anyone. That's when the government decided to take him in the house arrest in the place called Kimbali Harishiwe in 1969. That's where he died in the house arrest in 1978. Others say he was being poisoned in the island. Others say it's a lung cancer. As a Robben Island Museum, we are providing information of that. There are many ex-political inmates that fight against apartheid in South Africa. Why not everyone is being recognized as the same level as Dr. Nelson Mandela, Govan Mbeki, Walter Sisulu, Chris Hani, Desmond Tutu, and many more? The likes of Robert Mangaliso Sobukwe must be at least be recognized in South African history too, due to they play huge part in our freedom as a nation. 2 years after Sobukwe was released in the island, there were dog kennels that were built here. These two that are facing Sobukwe's house were dog kennels for dogs. It's about 32 German Shepherd dogs that were kept here. These German Shepherd were patrolling in the maximum security prison whereby your first tour was.